Hello everyone. In this session, I will tell you about the attachments on the scapula. In my last video, I demonstrated you the general features of the scapula and how to determine the site and hold the scapula in anatomical position. Now coming to the costal surface, the medial two-thirds of the subscapular fossa gives origin to subscapularis muscle. The subscapularis muscle is an example of multipinnate muscle. Coming to the dorsal surface, above the spine, the medial two-thirds of the supraspinous fossa gives origin to supraspinatus muscle, whereas below the spine, the medial two-thirds of infraspinous fossa gives origin to infraspinatus muscle. Coming to the attachment on the spine and acromion process, the lower lip of the crest of the spine and the lateral border of acromion process gives origin to deltoid muscle, whereas the upper lip of the crest of the spine and the medial border of the acromion process gives insertion to trapezius muscle. Coming to the medial border, the costal aspect of the medial border receives insertion of serratus anterior muscle. The first digitation of serratus anterior is inserted from superior angle up to the root of spine. Along the medial border, there is insertion of two digitations and the remaining five digitations are inserted along the inferior angle. So this is the insertion of serratus anterior muscle. Whereas on the dorsal aspect of the medial border, there are insertions of three muscles from above downwards, from superior angle up to the root of spine, levator scapulae, opposite the root of spine, rhomboides minor, and below the root of spine, up to the inferior angle, there is insertion of rhomboides major. So from above downwards, levator scapulae, rhomboides minor, and rhomboides major. The dorsal aspect of the lateral border gives origin to two muscles, upper two-thirds to teres minor and lower one-third to teres major muscles. Now this is the glenoid cavity. Above the glenoid cavity, there is a tubercle which is known as supraglenoid tubercle, from where long head of biceps brachii takes origin. Whereas below the glenoid cavity, infraglenoid tubercle gives origin to long head of triceps muscle. Now coming to the attachments on the coracoid process. The tip of the coracoid process gives origin to short head of biceps brachii and coracobrachialis muscle, whereas the superior surface of the coracoid process receives insertion of pectoralis minor muscle. The inferior angle of the scapula gives origin to some fibers of latissimus dorsi muscle, whereas the superior border near the suprascapular notch gives origin to inferior belly of omohyoid muscle. Now around the margin of the glenoid cavity, there is attachment of glenoid labrum and capsule of the shoulder joint. And the margin of the facet on the acromion process gives attachment to the capsule of acromioclavicular joint. Between coracoid process and acromion process, there is a ligament which is known as coracoacromial ligament. The root of coracoid process also gives attachment to coracohumeral ligament. And the superior surface of the coracoid process gives attachment to coracoclavicular ligament, which is attached above to the conoid tubercle and trapezoid ridge of the clavicle. So three ligaments are attached to coracoid process: coracoclavicular, coracohumeral, and coracoacromial. This is the suprascapular notch, which is converted into a foramen by attachment of a ligament. This ligament is known as suprascapular ligament, which is attached here and converts this notch into a foramen. Through this foramen passes suprascapular nerve, whereas above the ligament will pass suprascapular vessels. The spinoglenoid notch is similarly converted into a foramen by a ligament which is known as the spinoglenoid ligament, which converts the notch into a foramen, and through this foramen passes suprascapular vessels as well as nerve. Now there is a condition known as winging of scapula, in which if there is weakness or paralysis of serratus anterior muscle, which is inserted along the medial border due to injury to long thoracic nerve or nerve to serratus anterior, then when the patient tries to do protraction or tries to push against a wall, the medial border of scapula and the inferior angle become unduly prominent. This is known as winging of scapula. So that completes our attachments on scapula. Thank you.